Welcome to the video. Today we will be getting an overview on the braking system. It is not wrong to say that we ride the cars only because we trust our brakes. Braking system is one of the most important part of car designing and manufacturing, as it is primarily the braking system only that prevents any mishap or accident. Overview of braking systems. What is braking system and the brakes? It is a device or a set of devices used to stop any vehicle by applying frictional forces. Clearly, a brake which serves to slow down the vehicle should not be too weak. But interestingly, when designing a brake system, it should be taken care that it's not too efficient. A too strong braking system would expose us continuously to the ill effects of sudden brake application in a vehicle. If vehicle is stopped abruptly or strongly, the passenger may hit the front seat or whatever is there. Hence, too efficient braking system is not required. How do we achieve this stopping of vehicle? This is achieved by conversion of the kinetic energy of the vehicle to the heat energy, which is then dissipated into the atmosphere. What do we require out of a brake? The brake must be strong enough to stop the vehicle within a minimum distance. Brake must provide good control over the vehicle during emergency braking, and the vehicle must not skid. After prolonged period of application of brakes, the coefficient of friction drops and the property of brake material changes, which leads to less braking effect. This is called brake fade, and hence brakes must have anti-fade characteristics. Cooling of the brakes is of utmost importance and hence must be very efficient. Moving on the classification of brakes, braking systems can be classified on various grounds. Overall, we have considered three grounds for classification. Firstly, the construction of brakes that include disc brake and drum brake. Secondly, the method of actuation that include various brakes like mechanical brakes, hydraulic brakes, air brakes, etc. And thirdly, on the purpose of brakes that generally include two types. First, service brakes. Second, parking brakes. Moving on the classification of on the basis of construction of brakes, we get two types of brakes: disc brake and a drum brake. Disc brakes. A disc brake has a disc that turns with the wheel. The disc is straddled with a caliper in which there are small hydraulic pistons worked by pressure from the master cylinder. The pistons press on the friction pad that clamp against the disc from each side to slow it or stop it. The pads are shaped to cover a broad sector of the disc. There may be more than single pair of pistons, especially in dual circuit brakes. The pistons move only a tiny distance to apply the brakes, and the pads barely clear the disc when the brakes are released. They have no return springs. When the brake is applied, fluid pressure forces the pad against the disc. With the brake off, both the pads barely clear the disc. Rubber sealing rings around the piston are designed to let the piston slip forward gradually as the pads wear down, so that the tiny gap remains constant and the brakes do not need any adjustment. Moving on to the next category of brakes, we have drum brake. A drum brake assembly consists of cast iron drum which is bolted to and rotates with the vehicle's wheel, and a fixed backing plate to which the shoes, wheel cylinder, automatic adjuster and linkages are attached. Additionally, there might be some extra hardware for the parking brakes. The shoes are surfaced with friction linings which contact the inside of drum when brakes are applied. The shoes are forced outward by the piston located inside the wheel cylinder. As drum rubs against the shoes, the energy of the moving drum is transformed to the heat. This heat energy is passed into the atmosphere. When brake pedal is released, hydraulic pressure drops and the shoes are pulled back to their unapplied position by the return of springs. Now let us come to classification on the basis of method of actuation. We get various types of brakes: mechanical brakes, hydraulic brakes, electric brakes, air brakes, vacuum brakes and bi-wire brakes. Mechanical brakes and hydraulic brakes are the most commonly used brakes in daily life. We would be studying more about them. What is mechanical brakes? This type of braking system is one in which the brake force applied by the driver on the pedal is transferred to the final brake drum or disc rotor through the various mechanical linkages like cylindrical rods, fulcrums, springs, etc. in order to deaccelerate or stop the vehicle. Handbrake is an important type of mechanical brake used in almost all the vehicles. The handbrake lever pulls a cable or pair of cables linked to the brakes by a set of small levers, pulleys and guides whose details vary greatly from car to car. A ratchet on the handbrake lever keeps the brake on once it's applied. A push button disengages the ratchet and frees the lever. When the handbrake is engaged, the tension is created at the brakes and the brake shoes hold the drum from rotating, and hence the movement of the vehicle is restricted even if it is parked on an inclined surface. Now, hydraulic brakes. Hydraulic brakes or hydraulic braking system is a type of braking system in which the brake forces applied by the driver on a brake pedal is first converted into hydraulic pressure by the master cylinder. Then this hydraulic pressure from master cylinder is transferred to the final brake drum or disc rotor through brake lines. By exercising the pedal, brake fluid transfers this pressure to the brake pads. This transfer of pressure is reliable and consistent because the liquids are not compressible. The function of master cylinder is to distribute pressure to lines leading to front or rear wheels as required. At the wheel cylinder, a small piston is provided which is operated due to pressure application through brake fluid. The operation of piston is converted to movement of brake liners. In brief, when a driver applies pressure at a brake pedal, the mechanical force is changed to hydraulic pressure which is transmitted through the liquid to respective wheel cylinders and changed back to mechanical force by the operation of brake pads, shoes, etc. The main parts of hydraulic brake system apart from liquid pipes are brake pedal, master cylinder, wheel cylinder and brake pad shoes that are connected at the wheel. Now, braking system is a huge arena for study, and as with the advent of new technologies, there have been many breakthrough inventions or innovations in the braking system also. The two of the most widely used innovations in braking system are regenerative braking and ABS, anti-lock braking system. Regenerative braking is an energy recovery mechanism that slows down a moving vehicle or object by converting its kinetic energy into a form that can be used immediately or stored until needed. In this mechanism, the electric traction motor uses the vehicle's momentum to recover energy that would otherwise be lost to the brake disc as heat. This regenerative braking is particularly extensively used in the electric vehicles. Now we would be seeing the what is anti-lock braking system. We would understand the anti-lock braking system through a short video. So the matter, so what happens during braking is when we apply sudden brake, then the wheels tend to get jammed. This jamming of wheels may lead to a slip of wheels. To prevent this, anti-lock braking system was invented. This is the jamming of wheels when we press the brakes if anti-lock braking system is not present. In case of anti-lock braking system, speed sensors are present at each wheel that measure the rotational speed of individual wheels. The ABS control module samples this data continuously. There are rotational speed sensors present in each wheel that feeds data to the ABS control module, which analyzes it. If any wheel is found to be moving slower than the other wheel, then the brake master cylinder directs the brake away from locking the wheel, right? So this ensures that none of the wheel is completely jammed. See, when this wheel was jammed, when the rear wheel was jammed, the locked wheel is released, right? So no wheel is locked, every wheel is having a slight rotation, a slight appropriate rotation. This slight rotation prevents from slipping and provides control to the driver to steer. This prevention of slipping and provision of control to the driver, steering control to the driver, helps in preventing many accidents, as we will see in the further in this video clip. We have a car with an ABS and without an ABS. Brakes will both are moving at same speed, and then brakes would be applied to each of them. When a brake is applied to car without an ABS, the wheels get jammed and there is slipping of wheels. The driver does not have any control over the wheels momentarily for that particular moment. See, however, in the ABS, this slipping is prevented, and the driver can also have steering control because of the slight rotation of wheels that are continuously rotating even after braking. This not only reduces the chances of accidents, but also provides the driver with a better sense of control, and hence provides to additional safety. So thank you.